The March of the Super Rats by John Charles Giuca. It's a common cliché that everyone suddenly finds God when they come to prison. Misery and despair are religion's most successful recruiters. When I first came to prison, the old-timers used to tell the young wild boys, "They're gonna make your ass a believer." Now I know what they meant. People often tell me, "Leave it to the man upstairs." But that doesn't sound proactive enough for me. If the man upstairs sent his only son on a suicide mission, I don't even want to know what kind of excitement he has in store for me. As a young kid, I first saw a metaphor about faith when watching Indiana Jones cross over an invisible bridge that was only there if you really believed it was actually there. The moment you had doubt that the invisible bridge existed, it disintegrated, and you fell to your death. It was a pretty good representation to show people how faith is the bridge that gets you there. Then I grew up and became a skeptic. I saw religion as a crutch, and my thoughts were reinforced in college when I read philosophers like Nietzsche, who said, "A casual stroll through the insane asylum shows that faith does not prove anything." Nietzsche is the same guy who wrote the essay, "God is Dead." But then again, while I was in school, I also used to tell all my nerdy classmates that being able to finish a whole book didn't prove anything either. When I came to prison, my skepticism turned to outright cynicism because of my situation, my appeal denials, and because of the people around me, men starved of hope, the wrongfully convicted and the unforgiven alike. Usually the guys I see with strong faith are the ones afflicted with what I call delusional optimism. They have forever, natural life sentences, or football numbers, double digits, yet they know they are going to win their appeal and go home, as opposed to dying in prison. The problem is, many of them will turn out to be wrong. Statistics say that less than 1% of appeals are granted at each level. Ben Franklin said that the easiest thing to deceive is ourselves. I understand that a positive attitude may help them overcome feelings of futility and propel them to do an appeal at all. A little faith may mean the difference between being paralyzed with negativity or finding a reason to fight on, sitting down to write a blog post, or sitting down to write a suicide letter. But I don't want to have faith if it means living in fantasy land. I want the clear-eyed truth. Is faith a crutch, or does it have power and validity in itself? In almost every dictionary I check, the word belief is somewhere in the definition of faith. A range of scientific experiments were also done that led to a phenomenon called the Pygmalion effect, where expectations and beliefs in a host of different tests became a reality. In one experiment, teachers were told that some random students were gifted. These students ended up outperforming their peers, even though they weren't really gifted. You may think there was some confirmation bias here, or maybe the teachers treated these students differently, which affected them. It's possible. But in other experiments, rats were given to scientists with instructions to have them race through mazes. Some rats were labeled super rats, meaning they were genetically engineered to be super fast or super smart. But in reality, the scientists were misled about the abilities of the rats, and they were actually all the same. When the races began, the ones labeled super dominated consistently. The expectations and beliefs of the scientists, who were lied to in order to foster true belief, became a reality. Scientists have also discovered that the placebo effect only works when people believed they would be healed because of taking a pill. Quantum physics has also proven through experiments that the mere observation of or intent to observe an experiment through recording devices changed the outcome of the observed reality. When no one is watching, light behaved as a wave. But as soon as an observer comes into the picture, the light waves collapsed into particles, as if they knew they were being watched. Scientists say that this is evidence that everything in the universe is a potential something until consciousness influences it into a definite something. Quantum physics is called the science of probability. That sounds to me like the blueprint and foundation of the universe is a science of possibility. Examples like this seem to back up belief intention, the law of attraction, and faith. These things may just have an energy all their own. In the Bible, Abraham is the father of faith. For those of you who don't know the story, it's basic. As a test of faith, God told Abe to kill the one thing he loved most, his son. Abraham obeyed and was about to do it when God intervened and spared Abe's son. It seems like a simple parable with a straightforward lesson. The problem is applying it to reality. It's easy to admire Abe with the distance that fiction creates, if it's fiction. But most people in the real world with that kind of faith are narrow-minded fanatics or wild-eyed wackos who fly planes into buildings. Or are they? Abraham is revered all over the world. But what would you do if your neighbor peeked over the picket fence and said, "God told me to kill my son today"? That's troubling. But what I think about is this thought. Does my salvation from this place or from earth hell depend on having the kind of belief, will, and faith that Abraham had? Is everything a test? What if life is a battleground? When they tell you your faith is not rational and doesn't make sense, tell them that the rational man adapts himself to his surroundings. The irrational man persists in trying to adapt his surroundings to himself. Therefore, all change depends on the irrational person with love in their heart. Faith itself, if not accompanied by action, is dead. James 2:17. So have some faith so you're not a miserable bastard. Otherwise, no one will want to be around you. But in the meantime, fight until your dying breath. Written by John Charles Giuca on July 30th, 2017.